Hey guys, Dr. Huntington here. Let's look at the difference between foods labeled organic, conventional, and non-GMO. But first, let's make sure these terms are clear. Food that's labeled as organic means that it was produced without the use of synthetic fertilizers, pesticides, sewage sludge. I'm not kidding about that. That's actually part of the definition. It also hasn't gone through any kind of bioengineering, such as GMO foods, and hasn't been produced using ionizing radiation. Well, that's the definition that's commonly used for plant-derived food. And if we're referring to like animal products, like meat, poultry, eggs, or dairy products, organic means that the animals did not take any antibiotics or growth hormones, and they ate organic feed, and you know, had enough space to be comfortable by whatever standard the government defines as comfortable for that animal. So organic is a great designation, and you should strive to eat organic as often as possible. Now, it's important to note that organic is not the same as non-GMO. Non-GMO means that the food has not been genetically modified, meaning that the food has not been altered in a lab using genetic modification or engineering techniques. But it's still possible for the food to be non-GMO, meaning that it hasn't been modified, but still not be organic, because maybe it was produced using an artificial fertilizer or chemical pesticides. So a non-GMO food might be organic, or it might not be organic. But an organic food is always non-GMO. If a food is not organic, then the term used to describe it's conventional. And this is how you'll see it, you know, in the grocery store. Non-organic foods will be listed as conventional. So let's get practical here to make it very easy. Your best choice for good health is to eat organic foods as often as possible. And as we discussed earlier, those organic foods will never be genetically modified. And if you choose to eat a conventional food, you want to make sure of two things. First, if it's a plant-based food, you want to make sure that it's non-GMO. Another term for that is not genetically engineered. It's the same idea as non-GMO. And second, if it's meat, poultry, eggs, or dairy, you want to make sure it came from animals that did not take antibiotics or growth hormones. Okay, so here's the hierarchy, right? So on top, you've got organic. That's the choice you want to make as often as possible. Now, if you choose not to eat organic or don't have access to it, your next choice is going to be conventional, but you want to make sure that conventional is non-GMO, okay? And if you're talking an animal-derived food, you also have to make sure it was raised without hormones or antibiotics. So this is where you want to stay. You want to stay in organic, and if you fall down to conventional, okay, this is where you're at. Below that, you have GMOs and animal products from animals that were raised with animal hormones and antibiotics. You want to stay out of this category. You want to stay in the top two and preferably in organic. All right, so it's really just as simple as that. Okay, so keep that in mind when making your food choices today, and I'll see you in the next video.